Hi friends, wishing everyone a very happy Makar Sankrant. Welcome to my cooking channel Kitchen to Kitchen. Hope you are enjoying this Makar Sankrant with some awesome food and kite flying activities as well as get-togethers with your friends and family. Today I am going to share with you a very popular Makar Sankranti recipe for Tilgul Laddu. Simple to make and extremely delicious, especially in this winter season. If you enjoyed today's video, please don't forget to like, subscribe, share and comment. Let's see how to make Tiratse Laddu. The ingredients to make Tiratse Laddu are extremely easy. The two main ingredients are the sesame seeds and jaggery. In a pan, first we are going to roast a cup of white sesame seeds. On a medium flame, roast them for about 4 to 5 minutes until they release a nice aroma as well as change color like this. Now they are done, let's take them out in a plate. Keep them on the side. Next we are going to roast a cup of black sesame seeds. The best way to know that your black sesame seeds are roasted well is that they start crackling and also take about 4 to 5 minutes. I can feel the nice aroma. They are done, let's take them out in the same plate. Now roast 1/3 cup of desiccated coconut. You can always increase the amount of desiccated coconut in this Tiratse Laddu if you like its flavor more. Roast it until they get golden brown like this. Take them out in the same plate. Add about a tablespoon of unmelted clarified butter or ghee. As the ghee melts, add 1/4 cup of chopped almonds. Peanuts or cashews also add an amazing flavor to this Tilgul Laddu. As you can notice, we have kept little bigger pieces of the almonds so that, you know, as you bite into the Tiratse Laddu, they taste amazing. Tilt your pan a little bit so that the ghee rolls to the opposite side. In the same pan, add about 2 cups of jaggery. I'm using soft yellow jaggery. Also add 1/2 cup of water. With the help of a spatula, now we are going to kind of, you know, break these jaggery pieces that are really big and mix them well. Stirring in between on a medium flame, we are going to let this jaggery kind of come together and become a really thick and nice syrup. It will take about 10 to 15 minutes to really bubble up well. Notice here I have let it bubble for about 10 minutes. Let's check that it is done. So in a cold water, add a few drops of jaggery syrup. Notice that it has stuck together and did not kind of mix in water. So I'm just going to pick it up. See here, I can make kind of a ball with it. So our jaggery syrup is ready. Switch off the flame. All the roasted ingredients have cooled down. Just give them a good mix. We want all the ingredients evenly spread in the Tiratse Laddu. Now add the hot jaggery syrup. Once you add the jaggery syrup, speed up the next steps. Add a pinch of salt and some cardamom powder. The reason to speed up the process is because the jaggery starts to cool down and that will not be helpful for us to make these Tiratse Laddu balls. So it's very important that you start mixing it really well and then start making the laddus as soon as possible. So pretty much when the mixture is little warm. Here I have scraped all the mixture from the spoon as well. Apply some oil or ghee. Gauge how hot the mixture is and then on the sides start taking a little bit of mixture. I'm going to make small to medium size Tiratse Laddu. So just roll them into circular shape like this and here the laddu is ready. Similarly, gauging how hot the mixture is, continue making the Tiratse Laddu balls. I was able to make about 40 small size Tiratse Laddu with 2 cups of sesame seeds and 2 cups of jaggery. Store these Tiratse Laddu in an airtight container and enjoy them for next few weeks. But with such an amazing taste, I really doubt that they will last that long. To give a little bit of different texture, I had used black sesame seeds, but if you like only the white ones, you're welcome to use just those. If you enjoyed today's Tiratse Laddu recipe, please don't forget to share your valuable feedback. Have a great day.